Moving to see the types of transplantation that we can do. If we have the transplant is coming from the same person as in burns, when we have this burnt skin and we are going to cover it with skin of the same person, like for example we take it from the leg and we put it in the arm and the arm has the burnt skin. This is an autograft or autologous graft. This means from the same person. If we are going to do the transplantation from the same member of species but distinct genetic material, this is an allograft or homograft. This is same species, both different genetic material. The isograft or syngeneic graft. This is the same transplantation from another person, another individual, but the same genetic material. So this is between monozygous twins, because they have the same genetic material. And the xenogeneic graft or xenograft, this is between different members of species. For example, before we did we used to do the transplantation of valves coming from a pork instead of now by human, we make it with some artificial material. Now they are not coming from the pork, but before we used the pork's valves. So it was between the pork and human, they are different species. So here is different species. So autograft or autologous graft is from the same person. Allograft or homograft is from same species but different individual with different genetic material. Syngeneic graft or isograft is from a different individual who has the same genetic material. This is between monozygote twins. And xenograft or xenogeneic graft is between two different members of different species. And this normally functions well, but sometimes we can have rejection to the organ that we are transplanting. This can be a hyperacute rejection, or acute, or accelerated, or acute accelerated, chronic, or graft versus host. And another complication could be, for example, in the cardiac transplantation, if the patient now has a new myocardial infarction, it's not going to feel the pain, and so the patient can have, for example, sudden cardiac death, because he or she is not going to feel the pain, because when we transplant the heart, we're not transplanting the nerves that carry the sensation. So that could be another complication. Another complication would be, for example, in the kidney. When we transplant the kidney and the ureter is coming from the donor, and the bladder from the patient has no sphincter within the ureter. Here the ureter and the bladder. Normally we have a sphincter, but in the transplantation we are transplanting just the ureter without any sphincter, so we can have reflux flow from urine from the bladder to the ureter, and so the patient is prone to urinary infections and pyelonephritis. So We give as prophylaxis to these patients trimethoprim, ciprofloxacin.